Good morning to all of you. So in our previous class, we have discussed about what are the content that first chapter consists, then what are the railway engineering, what is the introduction. So first, we will know that railway engineering means it is the branch of engineering which deals with the design, construction and maintenance of the railway track for the safe and convenient or comfort movement of the train and passengers. Okay, so now we will discuss about the railway transportation. Okay, so transportation is the index of economic, social and commercial progress of a country, which helps. Okay, and the railways have their greatest utilization in the transport of large volume of heavy bulk commodities over long distances. It facilitates the long distance journey of passenger with safety, comfort and conveniently into short period of time. And the next, railway has a lot of advantages for the development of the nation by politically, socially and economically. So in this way, railway transportation helps to our country. So first of all, transportation helps to economic, social and commercial progress. How? Whenever the passengers or goods travel or transport by the railway engineering. Okay, so by this economical and economical point of view, that will be increased for the money. Social means all the peoples are travel together in one way. So in that way, the social community or social communication will be increased. And due to the transportation, the commercial progress also be done. Okay. Then the railway have that the greatest utilization for the transport, because the large volume or bulk commodity, okay, will be transported by the railway for the long distances with the less amount of money with compared to air transportation and your highway transportation. Okay, so next one is your, it facilitated the long distance journey of the passenger with safety, comfort and convenient in a short period of time. Whenever we have traveling in by the bus or bike or car for a long distance, that taking so many times, more times for traveling, okay, and the money also be more. But whenever we are traveling in the railway, rail transportation for the long distance, it will be take for a short period of time, and it will be comparison to bus or car and bike. Comparison that it will take less amount of money. Okay, so this is very comfortable for the journey of the passenger. Next one is railway has a lot of advantages. How it will be help to the nation by politically, socially and economical. So this is all about how railway transportation helps our country. Okay, so next one is your history of railway transportation. Okay, so before we are going or we are entry to our subject railway engineering, we should know about railway. Okay, about your railway engineering, about that past, how railway constructed, when it will be first proposal, when the way should be made. Okay, so first of all, your railway engineering, the history of rail transport in India begins in the mid 19th century. Okay, a British engineer, Robert Maitland Britton, was responsible for the expansion of railways from 1857 onwards. Okay, the first possible way to travel directly was from Bombay to Calcutta. And by 1875, about 95 million were invested by the British companies in India guaranteed railways. So in 1920, with the network having expanded to 61,220 kilometer. Okay. And the next one is your, how, in which year, what have you done? So first, your first train run in India, that at 3:35 p.m. on April 16th, 1853. Okay. A train with 14 railway carriages and 400 guests left Bombay Bori Bandar from Thane with a 21-gun salute, and it was hauled by three locomotives. One is your Sindh, Sultan and Sahib. The journey took an hour and 15 minutes. Okay, so next year is your 1832. So in 1832 year, the first proposal for a railway in India, which is in Madras, and this remained a dream on paper. Okay, but proposal is held in 1832. In next year, 1835 to 1836, a short experimental railway line is constructed at Chitradipet near Madras, which later became the Red Hill Railway. Okay, and in year of 1837, the first operational railway in India, the Red Hill Railroad, Madras, used for the transporting granite stone. In the next year, 1838, likely date of the first locomotive built in India. So you should know, ma'am, what is locomotive? Locomotive means your engine. Okay. Which engine helps to pull your train to move forward? This one is called your locomotive. Okay. So next year, 1840. In the year of 1840, various proposals for railways in India, especially around Calcutta and Bombay. Calcutta, the station, or Calcutta is your EIR, and your Bombay zone is your GIPR. Okay. So in the next year, 1844, the first proposal for the construction of railway in India was submitted to East India Company. The R. MacDonald Stephenson report upon the participability and advantages of the introduction of railways into British India is published. Next year, 1845. In the year of 1845, a railway is in operation near Rajmahendra for conveying construction material and stone for irrigation work and a dam across the Godavari. Survey work carried out for Bombay Kalyan line and an extension of the Malan Ghat for proposed connection to Khandwa and Pune. Okay, this way. And in the 1845, May 8, date of 8, the Madras Railway Company is formed. Okay, and East India Railway Company is formed in this year. Next year, in 1849, in August 1, Great Indian Peninsular Railway incorporated by an Act of Parliament. In next year, 1851, construction begins of an experimental section of track, that is Howrah and Rajmahal, for the proposed Calcutta Delhi link via Mirzapur. Okay, and in year of 1852, what should be held that in that time, construction of a line out of Bombay begins and a locomotive Falkland begins starting operation on February 23. The line is ready by November, and on the 18th of November, a train run of the Bombay to Thane trip for about 35 km is held in that time, and the Madras Guaranteed Railway Company is formed in the year of 1852. Okay, thank you. The next about the years and history we'll discuss in the next slide. Thank you.